nowadays it's probably pretty rare to find a game that doesn't have sound or music or something like that. And thankfully, Game Maker Studio allows you to add sound effects and music. The third resource down is sounds. So to add one, I can right-click and then click Create. And as usual, I'm going to get some sort of properties window, and I'm going to be allowed to change the name of this resource, and I'm going to use SMD for sound, underscore, and it doesn't really matter what I'm going to call it because this is just to teach you. So let's just call it 01 and I'll hit enter. So I've got sound 1 and a whole bunch of controls here, and how I'm going to change them really depends on what kind of sound I'm adding to the game. So let's first start with that. To do that, I'm going to hit this ellipsis here, this triple dot. And when I do, I'm going to locate a file somewhere on my computer. I'm going to pick this file. It's a WAV file called King Die. It's a death sound effect for a game I worked on. And then we got these controls down here. Now we've got a volume slider that goes from 0 to 1. And you see it's got kind of a float point there, so it's in decimal. So this would be like 0% and this would be 100%. And what you're doing is changing the absolute volume or gain of this sound inside of Game Maker Studio. So if I leave it at 1, whatever the volume might be for this sound, this will make it 100% to the gain function or the gain variable inside of Game Maker Studio. To explain it further, if I drop this down to 50%, so 0.50, I could also alternatively just type it. That would probably be a lot easier. What I've done is I've cut the audio's maximum volume in half. So inside of Game Maker Studio, when I'm working with my sound, my gain will be 1, but it'll now play at this 50% volume. I mean, the easiest way to show you is to just hit play, and then you'll hear the sound effect at 100% volume, and then drop it down. I'll type it in this time. And hit play, and now you hear it at half the volume it was before. But I'm making this my new maximum volume. That's something to keep in mind. There's an easy way to see how loud your sound should be, and that'll be shown in this video. So for now, let's just leave it at 100%. Let's just assume I recorded it at the best volume possible. You'll notice when I pressed the play button, it played once and then stopped. Well, if I needed it to loop for some reason, I've got this preview looped button I can toggle, and now when I hit play, now it's going just over and over and over again, and then I can turn it off and it'll stop, or hit the pause play button again to stop it, whichever one. The third button is actually rewind. Now this is a short sound effect, but if it were a song, like a background track, then it would be pretty long, and you'll notice there's no time indicator here. There's no timeline or anything to scrub through. So if I needed to snap back to the beginning of that track, I would just hit this button. That'll come up because I'll bring a song in here in a moment. We're going to ignore this button for now. That's for our group mixer. What we're going to focus on is the next part, which is attributes. So we've got 4 attributes, and they're kind of confusing because they have similar terminology, but here's the explanation. The first one is uncompressed and not streamed. So uncompressed means we're not going to compress this file when we finalize our game out of Game Maker Studio, when we're going to make an executable for people to play. If you're familiar with zipping your files, you're compressing it down. This saves on drive space. And the important part to that is your game doesn't take up a lot of drive space for people. This could be useful for small sound effects, or yeah, I guess if it's not going to take up a lot of space. But if you have a long music file or something else, you might want to compress it. If hard drive space is something, or solid state space, or whatever you want to call it now, drive space is important to you. So this is fine. I could probably just leave it like this for the sound effect, but I do have other options. And the next one is compressed. So this will compress my audio down to an OGG file. This is Aug Zorbis, I believe. This started as WAV. WAV is uncompressed and typically very large, being not compressed. But if I did want to compress it down to an OGG, I could toggle this, and not streamed. Now, I didn't explain that in the first one, but what it means is it's not going to read directly from your drive when it needs to. Whenever the game you're making requests that sound file to be played, it's not going to pull it from the hard drive or solid state drive. I'll just say drive. It's not going to pull it from the drive and run it that way. So if you had a song, it would be pulling it from the drive. In this case, we're compressing it, and we're not going to stream it. This means what we're going to do is the CPU will uncompress it and pop it into RAM, and then we can use it. So it's going to read it out of RAM. That might not be what you want if you don't want the CPU overhead uncompressing your file while your game is running, which leads us to the next one. This is a compressed option as well, but what it does is it uncompresses it when your game loads. You've probably seen that in tons of games that you play. When you first start your game, there's some loading that takes place, or it does it in between levels. But in this case, this happens when you first load up your game, and what it's going to do is pull the audio file from your drive, uncompress it, and then throw it into RAM. But instead of doing it when it's needed, when it's called upon, it'll do it when the game first loads up. So this could potentially use up a lot more RAM, but RAM's fast, so if you need quick access to your sound file during your game, that's a good option. Once again, not streamed. It's not coming from the drive. This will come out of the RAM. The last one is compressed again, but streamed. Okay, so this one now would be ideal for music files. So you'll have a compressed music file, which will compress down to OGG. It will live on the drive, wherever your game is stored. And then when your game calls upon the sound file, instead of using the CPU to unpack it into RAM or reading it out of RAM after it was, you know, loaded, it'll just read it right off the drive, compressing, uncompressing as it goes. So that can work for an audio file that's music. It wouldn't be best for sound effects. It's not necessary. Most sound effects you can just leave alone, just uncompressed. They're probably pretty simple. The more important thing to concentrate on with small samples like that would be your target options, and that is the next area of concern. So we've got four drop-down menus, and the first one is output. Now in the output, we have our channels. How many channels should your sound go to, be outputted to? You're probably familiar with stereo. It's probably what you're listening to right now. A left channel and a right channel goes to your left ear and right ear. But you can also select mono. This only has one channel, and this one channel will go through as many channels as you have. So it's one stream of sound that goes through both the left and right at the same time. It's not like it doesn't vary in any way, or 5.1 or 7.1 or whatever you have. There's also 3D audio for spatial audio that kind of goes around you if your game requires that. Although the manual does say if you're going to be doing 3D audio to select mono, but if you're doing audio emitters that use 3D sound, use 3D. I found that confusing, but I haven't dealt with 3D audio yet. The next drop-down is the sample rate, and this has to do with the frequency of the audio. It's set to 44.1. This is in hertz. You may have seen 44.1 kilohertz. This is just in hertz. That would be in physics, cycles per second. So that's what it's doing. It's sampling per second. And generally, audio should be at least double what humans can hear, and the accepted upper range of human hearing is 20 kilohertz. So this is 44.1 kilohertz. So it's a little more than double. And this is what CD audio uses. So it's fine to leave it at 44.1. To put in perspective, 48 is for DVD. DVDs use 48 for their audio. And there's also lower sample rates as well. You could probably just check out the sound file you have, find out what the sample rate is, and then just select this, which is probably 44.1, so you can probably leave it as is. Totally fine. The third drop-down is quality, and this is in bit depth, so you're probably familiar with 8-bit and 16-bit audio. If you know about 8-bit and 16-bit numbers, they get pretty large as you increase the bits. And this is how much of the amplitude can be resolved. It has to do with the dynamic range of audio. So it's really how much of a nuance it can pick up of the lows and highs of the amplitude. Most audio would be 16-bit nowadays. You don't even need to go higher than that for a video game. You could drop it to 8-bit, but once again, I would suggest just look into the properties of the audio you're importing into GameMaker, and chances are it's already 44:1 and 16-bit, which means you can leave them as is. And that will just deal with your frequency and amplitude. And the last dropdown is your bit rate in kilobits per second. So you've got a lot of options here. This is your compression. Typically, it's something like you multiply your bit depth and sample rate times your channels, and all of that together pretty much gets you some sort of bits per second. And that's usually a large number. So what you would want to do is compress it. And this will compress into an OGG format for GameMaker Studio. And it defaults to 128 kilobits per second, which is a bit of a squeeze, but honestly, for a video game, especially sound effects, it's probably fine. This is probably the one that's going to change how you hear it, how low quality or high quality it is, and how much space it's going to take up on a hard drive, and how much processing power is required, depending on how you're uncompressing it or compressing it. So you could leave it at 128. 192 has been used, 256 and 320 have been used, but that's usually higher quality stuff, especially for songs. So I don't know, I would say leave it at 128, unless it doesn't sound as nice as the original file you have, and for some reason for your game that's important, then you can increase the bitrate, which will not compress it as much. And really that breaks down those four target options. Your channels, your sample rate, your quality, and your bitrate all have to do with your amplitude, frequency, and compression. But most of the time, you could just leave it as is. And the final thing is audio groups. This is just how this resource audio gets grouped together and how these packages get loaded, similar to texture groups. I haven't gone into that yet, but I will in a video eventually. Point is, leave it a default for now if you're making a simple game. As your game gets more complicated, you might have to start packaging sound and music that plays together in some area in one group, and then, like, say you had levels, you'd have level 1 and all your level 1 audio would be in one, then level 2 and all your level 2 audio would be in another group. This way you can swap in and out of RAM without the game having to, like, look all over these different groups to find the ones it's looking for. It's just cleaner and more organized. The last option, though, for bringing in sound, which is pretty neat and new to GameMaker Studio 2, is this sound mixer. So now you actually get a time indicator here, which is really nice, but you can always collapse it if you don't need to see it. The importance of using this is to bring in more than one sound and then play them all at once, or play however many you need, and then figure out how much gain or like maximum, you know, volume they should have relative to each other. And this can be important. Let's just bring in an example. I'll start another audio resource over here. Keeping with the naming convention, we'll call it Sound 2. And I'm going to bring in this song. This song is Pixel Peeker Polka, the slower version by Kevin MacLeod of, I don't have his website here, but I will flash it on screen right now. There it is. Royalty-free music, but you can always pay him. I tend to do that if I can. Or you can always credit him when you use songs. So I'm just going to leave this as is for now. I don't need to change anything to show you the sound mixer. But if I wanted to add audio to this panel right here, say I didn't even have any, there are a few ways to do it. One, simply grab the resource and then drag it in. You can see this line comes in. Actually, there's a red X where I can't bring it. And there we go. So I can just drag them in like that. The other way to do it is to select multiple resources by using, you know, Shift or Control or Command, whatever you're using, and then right-click, and then you can say Open in Sound Mixer, and this will open up a new instance of the Sound Mixer with all the ones you've had selected. So, multiple ways of getting your sounds into Sound Mixer. Now what you can do is press, let's first put the loop on and press play. You saw when I put on the loop, it made all of them do that. This is a master control, this column volume. This will alter everything in this column. So I've hit play, there we go. So now I've got this sound, the song playing, and the sound effect looping. But what I'm noticing is maybe this music is actually too loud for the sound effect. So I can start dragging this down until it gets to a more like comfortable volume. And that right here is the beauty of the sound mixer. You get to play all these different audio tracks. It's kind of getting annoying. Let's just pause that. You can play all these different audio tracks on top of each other and see how you should mix them together using audio levels. It's that simple. You can also hit this plus to add a new sound group. And if I had other sound effects or music or whatever, I can put them in here and control them over here as well. And if I wanted to control all of them together, I can link the groups together. And now this is the same control bar for both of them. So I'm playing all of them together. If that's necessary, you can actually just keep adding more and more and more. So great tool to use if you need to internally, inside of GameMaker Studio, mix the audio levels for all your sound and music. Something, if you couldn't do that in any other program, which is very nice. Although I would suggest picking up other audio software if you need to, because it doesn't hurt to have other software to help you out. So that's pretty much it for importing sound resources. You bring them in like anything else, you create them, you give them a name, you can change the maximum output volume, which is what's setting 100% once you get into gain. We'll get into that later. Then you can select whether it's compressed or uncompressed, all the different CPU, RAM, and drive options. Then you can select all your different output rates and depths, which group it belongs to. And then we even covered the sound mixer, which is a great way to hear the different sound levels, the volumes of the different tracks, and mix them together and find the best maximum. And with that, thanks for learning.